Hello, Pythoneers. Do you want to empower your Python projects with the Gemini API from Google? I got you. Here's all you need to know. Go to ai.google.dev to create your API key. Just create an account, navigate to the API section, and hit Generate API Key. You'll need this to authenticate and interact with the Gemini models. Next, let's explore the available Gemini models and their pricing. For this tutorial, we're sticking with the free plan, but you can upgrade as needed. Here is a link to a list of all currently available models. Once you've chosen a model, you're ready to code. We'll start by importing Google Generative AI. Make sure to install it with pip install Google Generative AI. Here we're using the Gemini 1.5 Flash model, but you can explore others. Then paste your API key here. Then configure the API with your API key. Remember, never hard code your API key directly in your code for public projects. For security, always store it somewhere safe. Check out the linked video for more on this. This simple prompt function defines an input and passes it to generate content. Here, we're just printing the response text, but feel free to use the full response object to explore extra details. There's more data there for you to play with. When we run this code with the input, "How are you today?" the model responds with a robotic answer that hints it doesn't have feelings. Now, let's make it reusable by wrapping our setup into a class. Our Gemini client class initializes the API key and model, then provides a generate response method. This way, we can easily integrate Gemini into larger projects. And here's the code to call the class. This setup gives you a clean, scalable way to use Gemini's features across projects. With these steps, you're ready to start using the Gemini API in your own Python projects. If you'd like to see how to use this API for image-to-text or as a chatbot, let me know in the comments. I'm considering some quick guides for those too. If you enjoyed this quick guide, don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more Python tutorials. On the left is the next video you won't want to miss. Happy coding!